Come on, get back round here. Show the folks back home your tan. Well, don't touch nothing. Don't shake it. It's all set up.
Are you sure it's working?
Of course I'm sure. I can see the bleeding red light for starters. Come here. Oh, a few pounds of prime rub here, eh?
I'll get off, Larry.
Say hello to your mum.
Oh, mum.
Hello, Jeannie, the old dragon. Anyone else who knows this? Yeah, I hope you're all working your nuts off back home. Especially you, little Jim, because someone's got to pay for all this, hasn't he?
Oi! Little Jim!
Missing the best part of the day.
Not today, thank you.
I didn't come here for a basin full of ribaldry. Get down here.
You get up here.
I told you, boy, I will not enter the house where Lauren was violated.
She's been on holiday for 5 months.
I'll meet you on the threshold. Hurry up.
Sorry about the interference, ladies and gents. Normal service will be resumed as soon as possible.
You laughing at? Right. Now that's an official Maori dance, isn't it, Lauren, eh?
Sort of.
You mean sort of, you saucy cow? Come here! I got myself a crying, talking, sleeping, walking, living doll, eh?
Oh, by the way, coming back for our 25th wedding anniversary.
Yeah, and we're getting in the night before. So, little Jim, listen, I'll be faxing you all the details, which I want carried out, right? And I'm compiling a guest list and half. Now, this isn't just going to be a party.
This is
going
to be a party! Yeah!
Well, Bob, our little girl's coming home.
Don't be a git. We need the money for the heat treatment thingy. You want it to be a winning kennel and all, don't you?
Well, I told you, once I finished paying for the dog swimming pool, that was it.
Anyone think it's your money?
It's me who's having to embezzle it off Larry.
We're going to pay the money back when the dogs start winning, so it ain't embezzling, it's borrowing, you aardvark.
And how long's it going to take to pay him back?
Not long. Glory's going to be the champion if ever I saw one.
Please, boy.
Where's the old Morley bottle?
What sort of amount are we talking about? Oh, stop pretending to be Don Corleone, would you?
Oh, you're my son, I love you.
Look, sod off.
I am a brother. I am a father. Well, I love you. You're my people.
I don't know why they call him Little Jim. Should be Lucky Jim.
I thought we'd done rather well after the Pattersons' extended holiday, too.
Yeah, but not as well as he has, and he's thick. I mean, there he is, sleeping in his bed.
Eating his porridge.
It's your future as well.
Stephen Pilbeam's residence. Who is it?
Mrs. Patterson's mother.
What do you mean they're coming home?
Which bit don't you understand?
Oh, my God.
What's your problem? He loves you.
Exactly.
I shouldn't shed any tears over little Miss Rough Trade. She'll just have to readjust to sleeping in the stable.
If only she was all I had to worry about.
Why, what's up?
Nothing.
Come on, tell me. You know, I'll find out.
Mrs. Stevie, can I confide in you?
Of course.
I've been stupid.
Surely not.
Between you and me, I borrowed some money off the business. A mad time to pay it back.
How much?
I suppose it must amount to quite a lot. Dribs and drabs. Why does he have to come back now? I was going to pay him back, honest. Got nothing to pay him back with yet.
All I've got to do is steam the old labels off and stick him on a few bottles of plonk.
You've been helping yourself to his wine, have you?
Decent wine is wasted on the likes of the Pattersons.
What am I gonna do?
Yeah, he's a good boy. You like this, don't you?
Good
boy, yeah.
You
look good and all,
yeah. You sure you're not that dog's father?
Mumsy coming home soon, is she? Yeah, she is, isn't she, my little darling?
5 months, not even a postcard. I'm more of a mother to that dog than she is.
When Lauren gets back, see how he's developed over the months. All the improvements I've organised around here.
Forget it, Dad.
She's gonna be so chuffed.
She's in love with Larry.
Rubbish. She's a hostage. See what happened to Patty Hurst?
There's none as blind as them that will not see.
You're spending too long hobnobbing with that collie. You're beginning to sound like him.
If Larry finds out that we formed a syndicate against him, that he's financing, the stink bomb's really gonna hit the air conditioning. And Pops, you gotta body swerve Lauren. You go throwing yourself on her, you're gonna scupper everything.
Just because you're the big cheese all of a sudden, allow me my dreams and all.
Come on, ain't you up and dressed yet? I've got to get out of the airport. And this is Lawrence.
Live like royalty forever. You told me.
Yeah, well, we're abdicating for a bit. Pack your bag.
Oh, come on.
Little Jim! Hey!
I've become a bit of a beatnik.
I can see that. Nice time.
The apex.
Yeah.
You got everything arranged for tomorrow?
Everything. The banquet in Hill's been dressed this evening, and anyone who's anyone's going to be there.
Great.
Cuddly Tiger Bum still loves his Miss Moppet.
God, you gave me a hell of a fright. What are you doing here?
How's it been? You miss me?
Go away.
Has it been hell for you? I thought about you every day. You miss me?
But leave me alone. It's finished.
What?
Everything. You, me, the dogs. I'm back with Larry. I love him.
You can't do this. You kiss me.
Grow up.
She kissed me.
Oh, we're off. We're off. We're off in a motor car. 50 bobbies are after us. They don't know where we are. Yay!
So a good time was that by all, was it?
Yeah, great. Curry's crap in India, though.
Yeah, what's that all about?
Oh, yeah. Shall we give Miss Prezi a go?
Yeah.
Come on, then. Look at that, eh? It's a fertility, Watson, from a witch doctor.
It's just what I need. Cheers.
It's African.
Yeah. You've been blinding since I've been away, boy. Business-wise, you've done me proud.
Oh, you know.
That's why I'm leaving you in charge. I got a master plan. And you're the only bond I trust to help me see it through.
You going away again, then?
We're going to start a new life.
I'm going to become Mr. Playard.
We're going to spend more time together.
Mm. Mr. Leisure. Yeah!
Work, you know.
Of course it will. He was a witch doctor.
He'd have been anything you wanted for US dollars.
Yeah, I've got lovely hair. I don't want a sunroof.
That Pilbeam's here.
What's he want?
Gives me the willies. But he won't go till he's spoken to you.
I've got to leave this spinach on for an hour.
Don't half stink, Larry.
Yeah, but I got a beautiful head.
I'm sure he meant for you to eat it. Just that his English weren't all that good.
This better be good, college.
Hi, Larry. Welcome home. I got you a little present. Well, I say present. More of a token, really. Just to say it's nice to have you back.
You disturb me for this.
If only, Larry. If only.
Why are you speaking like a prat?
Loyalty. Something inside me galls when someone as generous as you is ridiculed. Ridiculed in his absence.
Go on, Ed. Spit it out.
That's not really my place to, Larry. All I can say is beware of those you trust the most.
Larry?
Not now, darling. Business. Little Jim. What's he been up to?
I'm practically certain, Larry.
You better be bloody certain, Pillbeam.
I hate to say it, but he's always had a bit of an eye for the main chance. I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
Are you telling me, Little Jim? Ah. I can't believe it.
Can't? Or won't?
I shall go through the books. I can smell a fiddle.
Larry, I'd advise you to take a clothes peg.
If you're wrong on this one, Pillbeam.
Hand on my heart, Larry. I only wish I were.
Larry!
Go back upstairs!
What? What is it? Gone all glassy-eyed.
Have you lost anyone lately?
Sort of. Well, not... Well, I'll get her back.
I can see a reunion.
A party?
A party, yeah, I can see a party.
Right, right. What's happening at it?
You see your old friend.
Yeah? Go on.
Don't go in like a bull in a china shop.
Me?
Bide your time. And you will end up the one.
Really? Oh.
Oh, little Jim's done marvels in here. Hey, he reckons you've been avoiding him all day.
Yeah, what's he know about anything?
What's the matter?
I'll tell you tomorrow. Nothing's gonna spoil my big night. And you are the guest of honour.
I'll tell it what Jimmy's done well in here.
Yeah, have a look at this. This will crack you up.
I really, really love you, Loris.
Hey, do it again.
I love you. What did I do? Come on, let's go get a drink. Come on.
Oh, yeah, that's nice. Gonna get yourself a man tonight.
What for? I'd only lose him again. I'm gonna have the time of my life, though, celebrating the return of my little girl. You're back, aren't you, lovely? I'm delighted for you, honest.
Thanks, Mum.
All that nonsense about you and Larry splitting up must seem like a nightmare to you now.
It's changed.
Glad you're happy.
I'm happy. He's concentrating on leisure. Said I made him see the light.
Do you reckon I'm too old for sussies?
I hope you don't turn into a playaholic.
Now, I'm in being a bit risque once in a while. No one's going to see him.
Mum, you ever found sixpence and lost sixpence?
Go on, I ain't heard it.
Move back, you bloody parrot.
I want you to know, Larry, that it's only my loyalty to you that has forced my hand in this.
If he's been playing piano on a till, why has he kept the invoice and wrote it in the accounts?
Well, perhaps he's not as bright as we thought he was.
Hi, Lauren.
Please, Jim, leave me alone.
I was just going to say, could we be friends?
I'm making a go of it with Larry.
Sure, sure. Don't know why, but sure. They miss you, you know. The dogs. Me too, but I'm no bull in a what's it.
How are they?
Gloria's going to be is a champion in the making.
He ruined my shoes, chewed them to bits.
The last 5 months, all the time, I've been doing it for you, you know, as my friend.
Do it for yourself, Jim. You love them enough, they'll repay you.
A swimming pool? I mean, what are you talking about?
A dog swimming pool. The new gym are flipping some kennels.
Which kennels? Where? Where is it? I don't believe this.
You work for little Jim, do you?
Give it that. I can't believe this. That bastard's been using my money to build up a rival kennel at Chapel Heath.
Tonight is going to be the best night of our poxy lives.
Let me in, Larry.
It's little Jim.
What about him?
He's been milking me to finance his own project.
What?
Haven't I treated that ungrateful git like my own?
You have, Larry.
You mustn't let it spoil our night. Tomorrow I'm going to kill him.
Cindy off of the EastEnders.
Oh, you would have picked her that, Ian.
Oh, you're his mum?
Yeah.
So how come you're serving?
Because he's paying me an arm and a leg.
All right, Margaret. What a horrible do, eh? He spends a fortune, still ends up looking cheap, tacky and common.
Frank McAvenny's just signed my apron.
Not you and all. You ain't been sucked in by all this throw money at it mentality, have you?
What would I know about a throw-money-at-it mentality, eh? I was with you for 30 years, now I'm going out with a teacher. You don't reckon she's got her eyes on our son as her toy boy, do you?
Don't talk ridiculous. You don't half come out with some cobblers, you do.
Only joshing. Little Jim's got more sense than to get involved with that.
What's the matter with you? What have you idiots done?
When?
Well, couldn't you keep your noses clean just...
What's going on?
Well, I don't know about you, but I am horrified.
Lauren, not tonight.
Well, his mother should be a guest, not working as a waitress.
I don't know what everyone's getting so excited about. She needs the money. She's going out with a teacher, for Pete's sake. She had the choice, I said to her.
Well, I'm appalled. I mean, I grew up with that lady.
Yet another example of what a... There isn't a word horrid enough to say what you are.
It was Mum who wanted to do it. Women. Oh, Larry, before you go, can I have a quick word about the Greyhounds?
It's a minute to midnight for you, little Jim.
Having a nice time, little Jim.
Not really. What's eating Larry's head?
Yeah, he's just got back. Sees you looking miserable. Cheer up, or he's going to think your solemnity is due to his return. Smile and the whole world smiles with you.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for the people's favorite, Mr. Larry Patterson.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, or should I say, friends. Friends. This is a delicious occasion for me.
Don't know what he keeps going on about friends for. Everybody here hates him. They're either staff or here for the freebie.
Happy day with the darling wife and me.
Now, I've had more fun in the laundrette drinking night, nurse.
Oh, my God, look, it's Donna. Donna bloody you. And he's only got Donna bloody you in here, the page freak.
She's been all of my life.
Well, for most of it, Popeye, she weren't born.
I've just took her around the world. And we've had a right blinding time. Yeah. But in all honesty, joking aside, everywhere comes a pretty poor second to Ilford. I mean that. Everywhere else is so far from the stove, for starters.
How's Jeff Ross got three goals and you didn't get any?
He's a gunman at home, isn't he?
My missus started to show a little bit of interest in my hobby. Hobby, eh? It's passion. Passion. Dogs. And we went away after a death in the family. And on this auspicious occasion, well, 25 years of happily married life to my dear wife, Lauren, I would like to present her with this small token of my esteem. All right, darling, get up, darling. Hang on, you go over there. That's it. Well, go on, open it up. People want to see. Our beloved dog of war.
Thank you.
For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow.
And so say all of us.
And so say all of us, and so say all of us. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow.
Sometimes I'm happy, sometimes I'm blue. My disposition depends on you. I never mind the rain. In the sky, I'm happy long. I see sunshine in your eyes. Sometimes I love
you. Bone, it tickles.
Love it.
May I? Excuse me, sorry. Little Jim, can I have a word?
I was on for a promise with her.
Look, I'm serious.
So am I.
It's Larry.
Excuse me. You haven't been taken in by all this glitzy tosh too, have you?
Oh, Jim, you absolute cretin.
The lady does protest too much, methinks.
It's Larry. He's on to us.
Me and you?
No. There is no me and you. Look, get everybody up to the kennels tomorrow at 10 o'clock.
This is actually a gentleman's excuse me.
Yeah, go ring the Samaritans. Come on.
Larry, what are you doing? You're hurting the arm.
This is it, babes.
What?
I've got the registrar at Whitechapel Hospital over there. I'm going to give him a cheque for a bloody electrocardio something or other machine. I didn't want you to miss out on getting your picky in the papers.
I was hoping to have a chat with Margaret.
Oh, don't waste your time on people like her. It's no use. Come on.
I'm so happy when I'm with you. I'm so happy when I'm with you. I'm so happy when I'm with you.
Yeah.
The prince is dead. Long live the prince.
Like you've never been away. All that dancing and approving village with the sun rising over the mountaintops, it feels like another life. Back in Ilford, all the problems that weren't problems then suddenly seem like problems again.
You know your only problem, darling. You don't drink enough. That's serious.
Your speech was, well, it has to be said, Larry, brilliant.
Weren't that bad, was it?
You're a better man than I am, though, letting little Jim sit around drink your champagne.
Don't want to ruin the do. 25 years college. So the speech was all right, was it? Oh,
fantastic.
What are you washing your hands for? You ain't had a pee yet.
I just want you to know, Larry, that I'm always here.
Right, careful, get over it.
There you go.
There you go.
Mind your head.
Careful.
Make sure she gets in, all right?
What a laugh.
You reckon it went all right?
Hilarious. I went round there, chat with loads. Everyone thinks Larry should move to barking. He is nuts. You see Lauren's face when you give her that stuffed dog.
I'm going to be following you home in a little while, babes.
What do you mean? Why aren't you coming home now?
Oh. Don't fuss on. I'll see you later.
Well, what are you talking about? Where are you going now?
What's she mean by tomorrow?
Nothing. Just that she sort of reckons Larry's on to us.
Genius.
He's learned everything from you, Larry.
What do you mean by that?
No. I mean, he's stolen all your ideas.
Come on. Let's get inside and see what we shall see.
Yes. Now, unfortunately, the blessed door's locked.
Get your jacket off. Right? Come on, get it off. Hurry up!
You're half naive sometimes, college.
Well, he's obviously found out.
Of course he ain't. Otherwise, what's Lauren doing coming round to the kennels tomorrow for? She's just fussing about nothing.
I start you thinking he might have said something tonight while we was wiring into his bubbly.
He's found out about me nicking off of him, though, hasn't he?
Well, that's a post, I grant you.
That's been bought with your hard-earned cash, no doubt, Larry. Oh, my God, Larry. Look what I've unearthed.
Ugh.
college. Yeah, yeah. Never mind about how I am. Are you down to Chabalief? Look, college, I don't want a workshop about it. Just do it.
Morning, Mr. Patterson. You're up early.
I'm up late, as it happens.
I trust the festivities were all they should be last night.
You got my dog?
Had to spend a lot of money.
So? You got me a dog of war pup?
Yeah, I sure have. I've got older Quinn, he helped me track him down.
Oh. What's this cottage like?
Oh, it's nice. I stopped over with him.
I bought that for him. I look after my employees, if they reach 65.
Well, he's well happy. And he's helped us find a lovely dog, Mr. Patterson. The finest one-year-old I think I've ever seen.
One bit of good news and a sea of bad, eh?
Where's Larry? Have you seen him on your travels?
He didn't come home. But if it's any consolation, I know how you feel.
Absolutely. Well, if you see him, can you tell him I've gone shopping?
Not being horrible, but with all that extra weight he's carrying, he's a prime candidate for a coronary itself. Probably why he's giving all the dosh.
I feel ill. I don't think I'm going to be able to get through today.
Your old dad will never let you down.
Still, we're done for, so what's an headache?
We ain't done for. We never will be, while Jim Morley's got breath in his body.
I'm not going to have another hangover for 15 years. Not banged up on the Isle of Wight.
You know what you are?
Right, you two. Cash or account?
Account.
Enemy HQ, sir.
He's discovered some discrepancy. Well, I'm leaving the syndicate. Well, obviously, you all know I'm back with Larry, and I don't want to jeopardize that.
What's with all the long faces, then? We're up and running. He can't do anything, so what's it matter what he knows? We're here.
He can't do anything to you, Stanley, but I'm looking at a serious fraud charge.
Well, Larry won't call in the police. He's not that sort.
Even if he did, you're looking at an open prison for fraud.
I meant he can't take the gear away.
What does he actually know, Lauren?
Well, he knows that little Jim stole some money from the business. And he thinks he's trying to start something up on his own, but he doesn't know what. He's no idea about all this.
Well, it's the biggest search since Mick the Miller that I might have a job.
Well, I'll talk to Larry. He'll listen to me.
We just come clean with him. Tell Larry everything. I mean, I like him.
No!
That's really what you shouldn't do.
Why not? He's been good to me.
So you've got to be bad to us?
Tell him you nicked the money by all means. If that makes you feel better, all well and good. Just say you blew it up the casino or on a fluffy, anything. Just don't put us in it. Now, I'm your dad.
Rancid smell of betrayal. My wife. My protege. Now your work starts. You can prove yourself and earn your stripes by exacting my revenge on a whole stinking pack of them.
If you ever went back in, you know, you'll come back in, won't you?
I won't want back in. I've made up my mind.
You haven't been taken in by all this tasteless tech, have you?
What tasteless tech?
The trips around the world, fancy dudes with dried up old has-beens.
Jim.
I mean, all this hasn't been for the money, but for the love, for the fun.
I'm Larry's wife.
You're not cut out to be.
I am.
Is that the lot of the low-life tap?
I think so, Larry.
I don't want to be reminded of that toad.
Larry, what about Lauren?
What? You're my marriage counsellor all of a sudden? No. I'll educate her in my own way.
I'm not wasting a plastic bag on you.
Larry!
Beautiful.
What?
Some days the bear will eat you. And some days, you eat the bear.
Ah. Cheers.
Okay, Stanley. You're next.
What for?
We'll think of something.
Just can't believe it. They just said they were closing the pub down because of the appalling standards of hygiene in the kitchens.
You're certain they were health and safety?
Yeah, my kitchen's spotless.
Fret not, Popeye.
I'm ruined.
I'll get it sorted. I'm on to something.
Same day Stanley gets lifted, same day little Jim gets a tin tack.
Exactly. You may think Jim Moore is a silly old sod. Let me tell you, I'm one step ahead.
Hello, Larry.
Oh, hello, Lauren.
What happened to you last night? Where were you dirty stop out?
You're right. I have been stupid. Blind, even. I mean, my single-minded pursuit of things material had made me miss so much.
There are some things, Larry, you just can't buy.
Oh, yeah. Like?
You think I'm stupid? I know that, Larry.
Just look at the state of you.
Sticks and stones.
You couldn't even keep a dinner lady satisfied.
What do you want, Larry?
People laugh at you.
Whereas they think you're a prophet.
Suppose you think you're made up here. Just because you was able to turn the head of my wife. But I know all about everything. Her. The computer. The vitamins, all mine. I paid for them. I own them all. Hey, did you actually think that you, bloody you, Jim Morley, could get one over on me? Me, Larry Patterson!
Do you want a cup of tea, Larry? You also paid for a little kitchen out the back.
How could little Jim and Lauren get sucked in by a cretin like you?
Beats me, Larry.
Get out of here.
I'm the owner.
I'm the owner? This place is mine. I want you out.
You can have everything here, Larry. On condition.
Go on.
Get health and safety of Popeye's back. Get your cronies on the plod to let Stanley out. Don't even think about getting little Jim charged. And slip me a few bob for my time and trouble in building this kennel up to the standard it is now.
I knew you'd sell. How much do you want?
And don't blame Lauren. She regrets her involvement in the syndicate. Wants to make a go of it with you. She loves you.
How much?
How much you got?
You can buy everything in the whole world. Some things just cost more than others. Get me the deeds or whatever paper you got on this place. I want to decorate Lauren's bedroom with them.
The reason I got involved was so you'd notice me. You were spending all your time with the dogs. I just wanted to prove that I was as good as you at something.
Darling, you'll never be as good as me at anything. But there's no need to blow up, because I ain't kicking you out. I'm only doing this to teach you a lesson. See, I'm the one person in this world that won't let you down. From now on, you grow up and start behaving like my wife.
Still, nice of him to let you stay. I mean, a lot of men wouldn't have been...
Got a bloody cheek, you.
Just come to say I'm sorry.
What does that mean?
I've let you down bad.
You let yourself down, boy.
If I could... If it weren't men. Slipped out of control, the whole everything. If I could just...
If me aunt had bollocks, she'd be me uncle. Don't patronise me with all this if. Be a man.
I've been a prat.
On the nose there, son.
Where is she? I think she got a bit tearful. Still, she's no one to blame but herself.
You watch your mouth, College. You're talking about a woman I love.
Sorry, Larry.
Tell me one thing, little Jim. Why'd you do it to me? Me? I thought we had something special.
Oh, we have. Oh, it's just a ridiculous attempt to keep me mum and dad together.
Oh, God.
When Dad got out the nick and mum had had enough, he'd come up with this harebrained scheme to win her back by emulating you and becoming a successful Greyhound owner.
Are you seriously telling me? You jeopardised everything to keep your mum and dad together.
Oh, stupid.
Oh, I admire that. The family. You're a real son.
I'm going to pay you back, Larry. Every penny I took, I always was. I've even kept all the invoices. I'll show you.
Don't worry about it. I own it all. Your father's sold up. Come back as my number two. I want you with me.
Waiter, Mo. I thought I was your number two.
Nobody trusts a stool pigeon.
What?
You're an horrible little sneak, Pillbeam. You've been trying to drive a wedge between me and my boy here, just so you can get in his shoes.
You'll never be half the man he is.
Larry, think what you're saying. I unearthed this whole ghastly plot against you.
Bugger off.
Larry?
Maybe we could find a niche for him somewhere, Larry. He'd done a sterling job when he was away.
This man. This man.
Oh, I love you, little Jim.
Never let you down again, Larry.
Larry?
You still here?
You lot make me sick. The way you stick together disgusts me. Never mind the old school tie. It's the old council rent book syndrome that wants abolishing.
Philbeam, before you go, I want you to drink some wine. You weren't going to pay me back, were you? But what really pisses me off is that you thought I wouldn't notice. You slimy snob. Crap.
You bastard. You spineless bastard.
Lauren.
That's all I've come to say. I don't want to talk.
Lauren, let Larry buy the bricks and mortar. Let him keep all the fancy gear. Let him think he's bought out the syndicate. But the soul that lives on in this dog here, he'll never get within a million miles of. We had a dream, Lauren, he can't buy that.
Over a barrel. I couldn't have bared little Jim getting done. It's bad enough him losing his job.
He'll get it back.
So Larry ends up in my kennels, my son, and the woman I love.
Back. I got a new dog, and tomorrow's another day.
Still, there's always tomorrow. Old Blubberguts ain't got a dog that could come within a million miles of our one in the van.
All I ever wanted was a reason to be happy. Happiness can be so hard to find. All I ever needed was for you to get to know me. Everlasting, shining peace of mind. Can't be so hard to find.
waves.
If it's good enough for the women on the banks of the Ganges, it's good enough for me.
Are they blessed with a man like Larry, whose whole life is geared to getting you those little luxuries? Answer no. I swallow any detergent and I'll break your legs, daughter or not.
At least with the syndicate, I used to have a laugh.
Syndicate? I soon lost their commitment when Larry let them smell his wallet. Fair weather friends. I live here too now. But another bout of your silliness and I can see us both out on the streets.
You are nuts.
No, you're nuts. Larry's worked so hard all his life just so as you...
He's gone from workaholic to leisureholic. But I'm still kept in a cage being thrown bananas.
What have I given birth to? God's sake.
Please excuse the redolence of school cuisine.
I tell you what, I'll get on the board, I'll sub you to get these walls touched. Haven't been done since I was there.
I must say I am rather tickled by the idea of an old boy on the board of governors.
Oh, get your vote then, do I?
You also have my godson in your employ.
Oh yeah, who's that?
But Stephen Pilby. Oh.
The art department hasn't changed much, has it? What's all that about?
Stephen Pilbeam, yes. He's your financial advisor, I believe.
Oh, college. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Financial advisor. Mm. He's your godson, is he?
Yes. Geography. Mm. So, what did you do when you left here? You went straight on to business school or something, did you?
Have a word, ref. Of course I didn't. I've picked up all I know on a job. And I've got people to do the job for me so I can concentrate on saving the world.
Oi! It's no use having it away with anything in there, pal. Come on out.
Dad.
Oh, son, how you been keeping?
How have I been? What do you think you're doing, nicking stuff out of the back of my van?
Oi, oi, it's your father you're speaking to.
Well, what were you doing then?
I thought I'd inadvertently left something in there.
Oh, cobblers, what?
Video camera.
Video camera? What do you want with a video camera?
I've got this plan.
No, go buy your own video camera if you want one. You haven't done all your dough, have you?
I've got a lot of overheads.
What are you dressed like Derek Hatton for? You want to get yourself sorted. You're falling behind.
Look, Sonny, while I'm out there struggling against the ill bloody wind blowing me back, you're still here working for old blubberguts. That's what you can't stand.
Oh, so you're achieving, are you?
Yes, I am, if you must know, if you care.
Well, how come I only see you when you're on the punting?
If you can't even be civil to the man who gave you the very breath you breathe.
Dad.
It's a sad and sorry state of affairs.
How come I always end up the one feeling guilty?
Maybe you should address yourself to that question. Get that. Don't keep old Porker waiting. Where you inherited this lackiness from, I'll never know.
Hello, Patterson's videos.
Look what a missus bought me. Insisted on calling it Lauren. Soft soppy cow, ain't she?
Bit cruel, isn't it?
Would you prefer to be in a £1 million house with me? Or stuck up a tree in the jungle waiting to be eaten by some AIDS-ridden monkey?
I'll take my chances in the jungle, thanks.
You don't think she's getting a bit restless, do you?
If she thinks I'm buggering off for another 5 months' sojourn because she's too stupid to stop being bored, she can think again. I got my aspirations to satisfy. She can start making her own fun.
Sounds fair enough.
Oh, yeah, you. Bone to pick. You never tell me college's godfather was a headmaster.
I didn't know he was.
Well, you best get onto the cretin ASAP. Tell him he's been reinstated. I got to become school governor. Stepping stone to the mayor.
But you sacked him.
What's the matter with a geezer? I sack everyone. Ain't he got a sense of humour?
Down on knackers, Jim.
You lot are all the same.
milkman, postman, dustman, all this cheery, cheeky, chappy, crappy. Well, I'm fed up. I've got no money. I'm kipping on Stanley's floor. I'm cold. I'm hungry. I've noticed hair growing out of my ears. Yet I've got to stay positive to keep the boys happy. And all I've got is my dog.
I'm skinned. Bangers have scored on Friday, Jim.
Shut off.
Cheers. I don't know how we manage without him. Do you, little Jim?
I haven't got a clue.
I always felt I was never fully appreciated.
Our unsung hero. Let's have some lovely bubbly.
All right, I'll come back on the condition that you refrain from calling me college.
Stevie baby it is, then. Luncheon.
You've
ever had birth on crew, little Jim?
No, neither
have I. If you'll excuse me a moment, gentlemen. Don't be silly, darling.
There's a blow-up doll next door.
Oh, you did notice.
Come on. Give me the knife, Lauren. Thank you.
I think we're ready for our starters now, darling.
Nice to be back, is it, Stevie baby?
Ladies and gentlemen, pray silence and raise your glasses for an earful of what I'm about to announce.
Well, here we go.
To the future. Mr. James Morley, Esquire, owner, trainer. Today is mine, and tomorrow belongs to me and all.
You haven't got your license yet.
Of course he ain't.
Mere formality, what is it with ye two of little faith? Did Jim Morley ever let you down?
Are you on the square?
No, I'm not.
Well, if you want me to get it sorted for you.
I'm not sure if I really and truly believe in that sort of thing.
Oh, me neither. Well, don't get me wrong, but when in Rome.
Something rather sinister about exclusively male groupings.
Oh, quite. Bring on a crumpet any day. That's what I always say. would you, excuse me.
Whenever I look at you, you're moping. When are you going to start to enjoy yourself? We're all out together tonight, aren't we?
We're only here because Larry can't enjoy himself unless he's got an audience.
Oh, you're just so negative.
Well, this isn't fun, this is business.
What do you want?
I'd rather be someone else. I'd rather be anywhere else.
Sulky Sue, I should have called you, or Moaning Minnie.
Bloody trite.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Look at the hypocrite guzzling back my shampers.
We regret that due to adverse weather conditions, this evening's race meeting has been cancelled. Patrons will be admitted free to forthcoming meeting.
I had a red hot tip for that race.
Well, that saved you another four fivers then, innit?
You're a very bitter little person, really, aren't you, Stanley?
Win? You? You couldn't win at anything. Never have, never will.
Who never has?
You!
I could beat you at anything.
Yeah. Ha! Cobblers.
Nightclub, is it then? For a boogie and a bevy?
Oh, yes! Well, maybe we could buy a video of the evening, play it back on cold winter nights.
Hey, look out there!
It's your stupid father, Gould.
Always the same, that Jim Morley. Always got to ruin it for everyone else.
He's carefree, and that don't half get your goat, don't it, Larry? Turn her on the sheepskin.
You're on.
Your bill.
Get him nicked.
Where we're going is a flash gap, so best behaviour. I'll introduce you to a few of the faces.
Extraordinary place.
Thought you'd live here, young buck like yourself. Give the headmaster a smooch, babes, but no tongies, eh?
Oh, I will. Grateful for anything I can get my age.
What's the SP there, then?
Well, maybe he's fed up with you showing off as well.
I brought you to a nightclub, so will you start having a nice time before I really show you what miserable means?
Little Jim. Now, he's an ex-student too, I believe.
Yeah, and his mum and dad. Though, to be honest, they're the other end of the evolutionary scale to Larry and my Lauren. Same teachers, some succeed, some fail. Ain't you got smooth skin?
Shut, don't insist on a jewelry. I don't want your money. Just a little favour. Well, favour, not really big enough to be a favour.
No, Dad.
It's no skin off your nose and it'll set me up for life.
What is it?
Good lad, I knew you wouldn't let your old dad down.
What is it?
Well, you know my dog? I just need a bit of a facility to go through the formality of getting my own a trainer licence.
Pardon?
Get me a loan of Cheddar Heat.
Absolutely no way. I can't believe you're even asking me this.
Who's it gonna harm you, tart? He's sitting there empty.
You're on your own. You're the dad. You're supposed to be the grown-up.
I am the grown-up.
Well, get a job then. I'm not my father's keeper.
Oh, yeah. Whee! Oh, yeah. Yeah. Get down here, Mumsy. Get on down, yeah.
Lovely.
Ah, yeah. What happened to you, Sir Soir?
Had to see this bloke sort something out.
Who are you? Yankee Doodle Donald Trump all of a sudden.
Right. I'm off up the Wooden Hill to Essex. Coming, Lauren?
Is Jean living here now?
Of course she is. Don't want my mother-in-law living in council. Besides, Lauren's got nowhere to run to now. Have you, darling? Funny old things, women. There's the headmaster, who ain't got one. And here's little Jim. He's got a different one every night. Seems to me. Well, I got the end of the stick with prickles on, eh?
I'm having fun. If it was someone else who'd done it, you'd be going on about how everyone loved them and how care bleeding free they was. Pick them pips up, College.
That dog stinks.
He who is without sin cast the first stone.
He's gonna buff you out, you know. Not by his missus. Why don't you write to the council and get your own gaff?
Don't you think I want to? Do you know, I've never had my own bedroom. Pathetic, innit? First was my brother, then my missus. Several weeks in the slammer, banged up with Catapult Charlie. In that bedsit with little Jim, and now here I am in a room above a pub with you and my dog.
What's she have to call in the middle of the night for? I hate you.
Yeah?
Have you ever seen The Graduate? Well, I'm in room 1002, the Riverside Hotel.
Right.
Come in.
Oh. Hi, Lauren.
Well, who were you expecting?
Sorry. I had to bring the dog. Couldn't trust leaving him alone with Stanley.
Never mind the dog. Come here, you mad sod.
Righto, then. Just time to the shower rail.
Congratulations. You've succeeded in breaking a great man's heart. Where the hell have you been?
I'm gonna go upstairs and then I'm gonna talk to him.
You better. He's distraught.
It's just that if we have a bit of time apart, I'll be able to see where I am in me head.
Okie dokie.
Trial separation.
Yeah. You sure you won't have anything to eat?
Honestly.
Okay, darling.
Shall we just see how things pan out?
Yeah. Okay. Bye, then.
Bye.
She's gone off again, hasn't she? Chase after her, Larry. Drag her back by her hair. there.
She ruined last night for me.
She don't deserve you, Larry.
Exactly.
What?
I'm not running after her again.
I'll put the kettle on.
I'm worth millions of pounds. And I'm stuck in my palace with a frustrated nutter. I must be start raving bonkers. Radio rental.
If she has any sense, she'll come crawling back to you on her hands and knees.
Well, of course she will, won't she? But she ain't got a clue. Now, the only way to stop all this nonsense of hers is to give her enough rope to hang herself. And while she's dangling there, I'm going to have a bit of fun.
Something awful's happened.
Love you. Do you want tea?
Yeah.
Two teas, please.
What's all this about?
I've got another little plan to net us some money. Guess what it is? I'm going to direct a film. All we've got to do now is find somewhere to live.
Jim, I'm not going to live with you.
Huh? What do you mean? Why not?
Well, for one, I'm married.
Well, surely you're going to leave Larry.
Yeah, but I want to spend a bit of time on my own.
Without me?
I've got to be on my own for a bit, or I'm going to go nuts. I'm fed up to the back teeth of the sound of my moaning. I've got to get my brain box sorted.
I'm really sorry, Lauren.
Don't be silly. Now, what have I done to you?
It's all right. All right. We've all got a lot to be grateful for. Especially that Ben Elton.
We've got the dogs.
I'm going to look the business in eye, Carmen.
Very nice.
Do you think I could have a manicure later as well?
Do you know what that beak said?
There's pandemonium back at South Fork. I know you was with her last night.
Well, I'm an attractive guy. I operate on a physical plane.
Why don't you just shoot me? Why are you making it so long and drawn out?
Loan me Chadwell Heath and she'll be nothing more than a business associate.
For God's sake, Dad. For a start, it's not mine to loan. It's Larry's. And so's Lauren.
I want to cut a movie there.
Cut a movie? Get in a van, you tosspot.
Winning with Greyhounds, the Jim Morley way. Little ad in Greyhound life. Can you tell me one person who takes that paper who's not going to speculate a tenner on our
Dad,
video?
Dad, when will you ever learn? What is it with you? You want to waste a bit more of your life, that's cool by me, but you can make your film up Wanstead Flats.
I see, so all my ideas are rubbish and all Larry's are brilliant, I suppose.
Yes. And if I hear any more about you and Lauren,
Yeah, I know. I'm brown bread, dead meat, finished. I'll never stack shelves in a video warehouse in Ilford again. Quake, quake.
Our woman is the sweetest thing, on that we all agree. But once she's got a wedding ring, a man's no longer free. That's the way I'm safe, and single. And Mary, I will be.
Anyway. Larry, Godfather wants another meeting. Now, remember, you said if there was anything you could do for him... Well, I think there might be. So, I told him to tip up for dinner this evening.
Get me a bird. As you know what I say. If you don't want to lose it, you got to use it.
I beg your pardon?
No, I'll get one of my own, but I just ain't got the time.
You've got Mrs. Patterson.
We're having a trial separation, and it's going brilliantly.
But, Larry, how?
Look, it's quite simple, College, even for you to grasp. Get out there and find me a girlfriend.
Well, what sort of lady do you want?
I want a posh one, like you. Then if we have a row, she can pay her own cab fare home.
Hello, Larry.
Forget to pack your toothbrush.
you smiling at me?
Yeah, bog off, College. Get on with the task in hand. Cock up this time and you're back on firing.
Business proposition, Larry.
You shouldn't really be in here, you know, my little scorpion. Temptation beyond endurance, huh?
Let me have Chadwell Heath. I'll support myself and I'll never ask you for another penny again.
Get out of here! Chadwell Heath! You got a short memory, ain't you? It was your fraternising with them lowlifes down there what sent you mental. Duffed in a brush, you.
That's a no, then, is it? Shirley Bloody Temple.
There was a girl out Romford way whose parson I should wed. But if my horse could only cook, I'd marry her instead. And that's why I'm sifting it together.
If you're too selfish to ask one of your chums to oblige, I don't see what choice I have.
Oblige?
Shh. Hello? Is that the Wendy Kite Escort Agency? Yes, I will.
And he's expecting Princess Di.
Well, he's so thick he won't know the difference. We'll just have to brief her well.
If he's so thick, why are you his servant?
Because when the master's away, the servant looks after the house. And he can always have the locks changed.
So what do you want to become a menial for? Your fiscal future secure with me. Through our dog.
You know I care about the dog. I've told you, we're business associates, and he's our business.
Well, what are you bothering with all these je ne sais quoi for? He's gonna make us rich.
Oh, yeah, so I just flash my business card at the landlord, do I? Well, I've gotta pay me rent.
Don't give up on me, baby.
I love the dog. I've got faith in both of you. It's just, I don't want you to think, you know, oh, we've been through all this.
You're my business associate, period. Living proof Hitler never shot Eva Braun in that bunker.
I think we're going to have a real meaningful relationship.
You miss me?
Oh, not half. Yeah, race coming up. Choose a number.
Eight.
No, between one and six. Bless her, sweet thing. Eight. Oh.
Three.
All right, three, eight.
Hello, Mr. Patterson. Mrs. Patterson, excuse me.
Do you know her or something?
I went to school with it. Take this. Excuse me, do me a favour. This is the straw that broke the camel's back.
Well, how's that possible when the camel's a spineless bastard?
Why are you doing this to me?
Oh, the entire world revolves around Larry Patterson, does it? I needed a job, I went to the job centre and I got a job.
I'll pay you double, whatever it is they're paying you, not to work.
You really haven't got a clue, have you? You poor little baby.
This is about your belief, isn't it?
No, Lauren Patterson.
Have it. It's yours, you money-grabbing cow.
Oh, how gracious.
I suppose you think you're going to be able to train dogs at Chapel Heath. You earn more money selling matches outside Bethnal Green Tube Station. Your trouble is, you think you've got some talent which I've ever suppressed all these years. Well, you just get bloody out there. I can't wait to see your face when you discover you know nothing.
All right, Master. How wonderful to see you again. Let's hope the weather's a little more clement this evening.
But isn't that your wife?
Not necessarily. You know everybody here, of course, don't you?
Well, your appointment is almost certain.
What do you mean, almost?
But we are in desperate need of a sports ground. If you could arrange for us to borrow some land to be turned into football and cricket pitches, the other board members would be so grateful. Your name will quite naturally float to the top of the pile.
I thought we could offer in Chadwell Heath.
Where do we come from all of a sudden?
As it's lying dormant at the moment.
And presumably there's good copy in businessman utilising wasteland for the benefit of local youth.
Well, we could get rid of the buildings.
Excuse me. Can we go home now, hon? I don't want to rush things, but I've got to see someone else later.
Oh, fantastic. That's really generous of you, Larry.
Good night.
Come on. Oops. There you are. Yesterday you were dirtying them. Today you're scraping them clean.
Yeah, and I never felt so bloody marvellous.
Right. If I pan down off the sign, then follow you two round and down into the stadium, fly on the wall style.
But they're never going to let us in there with that camera, so let's just cut the Steven Spielberg crap and go for a pint.
You've got the concentration of a plum. What's Faceache up to?
It's kung fu.
No use doing that around here, Popper. While you're bowing, somebody will wrap a glass ashtray over your head. Come on. Well, where are you going?
Home.
We're on a recce.
Jim?
Ah, hi, Lauren.
We got it. Chadwell Heath.
How do you mean?
I mean, we've got the kennels as a backdrop for the film. Well, I think we can allow ourselves a business hug, can't we?
You sure? I mean, only if you... I mean, I don't want you to know.
Don't go all pathetic on me.
I'm world famous in Ilford for my unpatheticness.
It's all so lovely.
Yeah. And yet they still insist my 11-plus papers weren't mixed up.
What the hell's going on?
Come and catch me, big boy.
Uh-oh. Wait there. I'll go and get you a cosy.
Get your caps off and get in before I drag you in.
I've got to get me trunks.
And I take them off with my teeth, I suppose. You men, all the same.
Oh, my gosh. Lauren. Come home.
What's happened?
It's too horrible to talk about.
Have you had a sherbet?
You've been right. I've been wrong. Come home. I want to live happily ever after with you. I suddenly realised you're the only person I ever want to kiss.
Look, Larry, we're having a trial separation. We've already agreed, so stop all this nonsense.
But you don't know how I hurt.
You prang the Bentley or something?
Come back before you have to come crawling back on your knees.
Look, Larry, stop playing games. I'm living on my own for a bit. We've already discussed it. I'm living on my own for as long as it takes me to sort out what I want. I can't be your appendage forever.
Why don't I pay for you to go and see a psychiatrist?
Because this way, if I do come back, it would be because I want to.
Right. I'll go and make sure all the little angels are safely gathered into the hall and give you a bit of a build-up. The man who's giving us the new sports field. Free.
You gotta stop this charade, Larry. You're letting in tears. I can feel it in my water.
Don't this moment fill you with pride?
No fear. You've already promised Chapel Lead to Lauren. What are you going to do? Divide it in two?
The subject is taboo. I'll sort it out in my own inimitable way when Lauren's back with me.
She's been there for 2 weeks now. It's got to be sorted now.
Yeah. But I can do what I want, though, can't I?
No, Larry. Don't say that kind of thing. It scares me.
Your pooper goes too quick. Leave it to me, boy. Have I ever let you down? Hey?
Well, you have a wonderful facility. I can say with no fear of contradiction, your owner trainer license is on its way. And is your wife going to be your kennel hand?
She's somebody else's wife.
But yes.
Well, all the best then.
Cheers. Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye now.
Bye. Ta-da.
We got it.
Now the cameras can start to roll.
What are we going to do with all the money?
Do we get it?
I thought I was useless.
No, I never said that, Jim.
And I was only joking. Don't forget I own 25% of that dog.
Don't I, darling?
Don't I, darling?
I've only got a couple of jumpers. You can check the towels if you like. I've seen you roughing it with that Jim Morley. Don't think you're putting one over on me.
Mum, I need a bit of support.
You need your head looking into. You being happy, living in squalor is one thing, but you're blatant. What's it for everybody else?
What do you mean?
You've always been selfish. As a little girl, you was. I suppose it's stupid to expect anything different now. You're pushing Larry too far. And you won't know the line till you've stepped over it.
Do me 500 copies of this, and I'll be your best friend, and I'll give you a squillion million pounds.
You take the biscuit, you do. Cavorting around with a boss's wife, and then you slime in here to avail yourself of his equipment.
Has Larry sacked you yet? No, he hasn't. So stop your fussing and do me 500 copies.
I bloody well know the score.
She's my business associate, pure and simple.
Tell you what, you go see Mum. I'll copy your video for you. Can't say fairer than that.
You always want something in return, don't you? I'll try. Glory's gonna be, he's got his grading coming up.
Go see Mum, please. I never ask nothing of you.
I will do. I really must.
No, it would never have worked between me and Reg.
What's you gonna do now?
Got a rope.
Still can't believe you had an affair with me old drama teacher.
Well, if I'd only slept with your dad, I would have hated to die wondering whether that was it.
I have got a rope, as it happens.
I've been offered a transfer down to Billericay.
Are you going to go for it?
Well, the trouble is, the council still think I'm with your dad.
Well, what's he got to do with them?
Well, there's a sort of attached to the house.
What are you bleating on about?
Well, a sort of job. I mean, I had to apply for it for your father. I faked his signature on the application form. Well, I thought we'd be back together again by now and everything in the garden would be rosy. Jim's not going to want to go anywhere with me now, is he? While he's dreaming of making his fortune.
You two are as bad as each other. You deserve each other, I swear. What is this job?
Caretaker. Of this lovely little estate the house is on. All little old grannies. I thought, well, would have been nice.
Yeah, would be.
Another glorious day in the annals, Stretch.
Yeah, isn't he just the best pup ever?
Yeah, and he's all mine.
Yeah. Have you heard the racing manager talking about that pup running out of the Rye House?
Hey?
Reckons it's red hot, too.
Well, you know what to do about it then, don't you?
How do you mean?
How do I mean, you stick insect? Get up there and buy the thing. Here.
Why'd you promise them both it, Larry?
But look, actually, there is no dilemma. Just sign it over to my godfather.
Listen. I ain't just going to snatch it back off her, am I? Because how's that going to look when she's back with me? Any road. I've got a couple of months left before I have to get it ready for the school.
You've got to sign the form for the council now, though.
We've got to get it sorted, Larry.
Yes. And you promised that land to the school in front of an assembly full of poor, helpless children in need.
What's occurring here, then?
I'm sorry, Jim, she won't be placated.
Hey?
Well, you know.
What about if I get the duvet cleaned? Besides, why didn't she keep her bedroom door shut? The dog wouldn't have been able to get in then.
I'm sorry.
Where am I supposed to go?
Come in. It's this important stretch.
Oh, I'm sorry, Gov. I was just going to fill you in about that dog running out of Rye House.
You bought it?
Not exactly for sale.
Everything's for sale. Some things just cost a bit more than others. Go back and up the price.
Wouldn't help. It's owned by a James Morley. Kennel hand one Lauren Patterson.
Hand me that contract, Cottage.
To be perfectly honest, Larry, I'm outraged for you.
What you gonna do, Larry?
Torch it. Raise it to the ground. Get it cleared, ready for a sports field. If you wanna go, son, go now.
I'm with you.
If you're with me, I want you with me 110%. I mean it.
Maybe you should go, little Jim. I mean, as your father.
I'm with Larry. Mum? Mum, are you on your own? Is that caretaker's job still on offer?
Well, I hope it does sell. Because you've got nowhere to live, and I've only got 20 sovs to my name.
Got the videos, and the dog, two surefire winners. As eggs is eggs. And tonight we're going out to celebrate this upturn in our fortunes.
What with?
Your 20 quid at the Burnie in Romford.
Who's going to put that towards me rent?
You'll never have to worry about your rent again.
And if this fails?
Can't do, Lauren, it can't do. I'll be so far down, I won't be able to get back up again.
The Burnie it is, then. Big steak, eh?
Yeah, steak and chips and peas.
This is the first thing the old man's ever done well.
And now you're going to destroy it. Where's all this working class East End family kinship stuff one hears so much about on 40 Minutes? What are we going to do with this dog? Torch it?
Your parents related. Go sit in the car and sound the hooter if someone comes. Unless you want to throw the match. Thank you.
The end.
Now, you're sure there's nobody in there, mate?
Only my life. Don't worry about it.
Just like my dreams, they fade and die. All the videos are gone.
Well, that's a relief.
What do you mean? I was supposed to be watching it this morning.
Nothing.
What?
He would have been the laughing stock of the Greyhound world.
What do you mean it was no good?
It was crap. You know, my dad. Paraffin eaters don't just fall over on their own, do they? He knew it was just another Jim Morley disaster. Couldn't face up to it with you.
He did it himself.
It's all over, Lauren. You gotta tell him. You're doing the wrong thing by him, by yourself. And everyone if you carry on with this game.
I'm only his business partner.
That's not what he thinks, is it?
Am I being selfish again?
You know what's gotta be done, don't you? You gotta tell me Dad to grow up and go back to me mum. And you go back to where you should be.
Everything that's dear to me is passing into history. There's nothing left at home to see except the place where you should be.
Look at this gaff. Mr. and Mrs. Lord of the Manor Morley.
Come on, let's go. Oh.
Oh, nice lot of land to run the dog. This fresh air will sit in good stead for the semi. Come on.
Come on, there are two women in my life. I'll best photo to you now to remember just what you look like before you start to overwrite them, eh? Oh, let's face it, you're both getting pretty near your sell-by dates.
Oh, cheeky sod, isn't he, Lauren?
Here, Lauren, don't drown yourself yet, you daft cow. I'm gonna let you parade the dog at the semi-final, if you're nice to me. Lauren?
I once had a woman. She treated me too kind. I took her for granted. I thought that she'd always be mine. But now I'm a loner. I don't like being by myself. The kind of love I'm looking for, I can't find with nobody else. Boy, don't take your girl for granted. Boy, why don't you listen to me? Take your girl for granted.
neither, Ricky. Can you believe it? Me neither, pal. You like it here as much as I do, don't you? Below Ricky.
I love it, me. Love it.
Larry?
Me dog about to do the business for his dad. The missus indoors singing her lungs out.
Yeah, she certainly seems to have undergone a metamorphosis.
Nobody loves a smart-ass college.
Sorry, Larry. I was just delighted for you. She's finally realised what a lucky lady she is being married to a thoroughly decent bloke like you.
You looking after my future All Britain champion stretch?
There's not another dog to touch him in his semi. Son of War will be in the final, all right, so you can count on that as sure as I'm standing here.
It's not to get into the final, it's to winning it. Don't forget that stretch.
Well, Jim Morley's dog's the one we got to beat.
What are you implying?
Well, he's got a hell of a dog, sir. We all know that.
Better get your finger out.
It'll be close.
I don't care. That's all that's going to separate them, as long as my Son of War is the one in front.
Oh, we'll have his measure all right, sir.
Yes, we'll just make sure that you do stretch. All right.
He's like a coiled spring. He's so hot, wouldn't surprise me if he caught the hare. So you're
going to
be at my semi tomorrow?
Sure. Larry's the day after.
So whose favours will you be wearing for the final, then?
Don't be a dork.
Maybe I am a dork. Colonel Mustard, in the conservatory, the lead piping.
Wrong.
I meant the rope, Miss Scarlet with the rope.
It's nice to have you here, little Jim. Billericay ain't all that far.
Billericay ain't all that.
You like it here, though, don't you, Mum?
Of course we do. Bloke who started up the Pilgrim Fathers come from Billericay.
Do you like it here then, Mum?
Yes.
Going out with Debbie again.
Why?
What do you think?
Ha-ha! Miss Scarlet, in the library, with a candlestick.
Wrong.
Wrong.
Debbie, shove off.
Right down my head, have I?
Please, Debbie, go home.
This little girl stinks out in the mornings, you know.
You don't want to have to bother about that. You've won me hard now, eh? Go on.
Little Jim, what are you doing up so early?
Morning, Larry. Post?
What are you doing up so early?
What are you doing up so early?
Where's some visiting?
Anyone I know?
I'm on the board of trustees, as you're well aware.
Great, Larry, you haven't left yet. Couldn't drop us off at the precinct, could you?
Morning, Lauren.
You're up early.
So's everyone else.
I've got to take special needs kids to Epping Forest this morning.
Both my wife and I are remarkable people. You're in charge all day today, little Jim.
They let you down before, Larry?
Yeah. What's this then, eh? Oh, come on.
You.
Don't sound too disappointed, please.
You're early.
Never mind about early. The syndicate's reunited. Long live the syndicate.
Larry, lay off, all right?
What is it?
Nothing. Nothing what? To do with you.
No, it's personal, right?
I'll leave him, Larry. He's gone all red, look, Beetroot.
Oh, go on, let's have a butcher's. I won't say nothing.
You? You're a gas bag.
Leave me alone, like Lauren says.
Yeah, you big bully.
You don't want to show me? This is plain prerogative. I might have hoped, though. Maybe I was naive. I mean, I didn't think we had any secrets.
It's not like that. It's just that...
No, I ain't going to force you. I shan't pull rank. Yeah, I got you! What's this all about? I love you. Will you marry me?
It's mine.
Oh, yeah? Writing love letters to yourself, are you?
It's mine. For Debbie.
Debbie?
I wrote it down because I was too shy to come out and ask her direct, like.
Well, she ain't exactly going to say no, is she? I mean, you got to be the best prospect she's ever likely to have.
I didn't want you to think I was softy. That's why, like, I was hiding it from you.
To thine own self be true.
Right. I'm going to be the best man, then.
Well, I was toying with the idea of one of them lengthy engagements, actually.
Actually, it's ample time you made an honest woman of that girl. Well, she's got what I call a common face, so she needs a wedding ring for a bit of respectability. Oh, our little boy's getting wed, Lauren! I'm going to give Debbie a ring right now.
Where's my investment, then? 25% of the next All-British Champions mine. Where is it?
In the garden with the other 75%.
Jim's dog starts winning, and suddenly you two want to start driving us everywhere.
I've always loved that dog, and I, Jim? Tell her.
It was me what found room at the inn for it. Not just a lowly stable, neither, no.
No, my bleeding bedroom.
Do us a slice of toast, Margaret. A bit burnt with smooth peanut butter.
What, you think I've forgotten what you like all of a sudden?
Does the cleaning and the cooking for the old folk. Loves it. Still take sugar, chaps? Any, you know, word? Seen hiding a hair of, what's her name? Lauren. She been around? Or not? Just wondering. What?
Oh, I was having me dinner up at George's the other morning. She walked past the window. I'd give it a knock and yelled.
Straight past, didn't she, put by?
Like something she stood in on a hot day.
Like Terry and June these days, her and Larry.
Always rowing.
They're like a couple of lovebirds.
I'm not bothered. I mean, I ain't even giving it a moment. I thought about it less than... something I haven't even thought about. I ain't bothered. How someone could love a bloke who looks like a toad is beyond me. Cheers, love.
I can now do a table display. So, life hasn't been a complete waste of time.
I hear you were at the colour therapist's.
Yeah. My mum thought she'd won because she was spring and I was autumn.
Are you sure you're happy?
Don't even think that question again.
Now, Debbie, make sure he asks you properly. And if he don't, you come and get me and I'll beat him about the head and dock his wages, eh? Right, here you are, little Jim. There you go. I'll make myself scarce. Study. He's going to pop the question.
I was the only girl in my class who hadn't been engaged at least once. Well?
What then?
Ask me then. Properly. On one knee.
Ooh, lugger, 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 ooh, lugger, 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 I'm your surrogate father. Oi, ooh, lugger, 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 ooh, lugger, 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 I sold you for a fiver. Well, come on, sing along a cockney.
Back home.
Don't you like to see the air that you breathe, eh?
Ilford.
I'm gonna go and stretch the cobwebs from me legs.
What, you mean you haven't got rid of them with all that walking you've been doing lately?
What's the matter with old Jimbo then, eh? On this our night of triumph.
Oh, he's just a bit anxious about the race tonight. He's different than Billericay.
We were better off on our own, Popeye. I've forgotten about his periods. Be dancing any road. It's an engagement dinner.
Do you want some warm milk?
Do I look as if I'm about to die or what? I can't make us a little sandwich, Mumsy.
Oh, Larry, you're just about to go and eat.
I said little. Go and get changed, you pillock.
I just wondered, any chance of having our celebration tomorrow night?
It's my semi-final tomorrow. Don't be so selfish.
Well, it's just that I've arranged to meet someone tonight.
We'll have to cancel.
Well, if he's got something planned, I mean...
Oh, I don't give a monkeys. I'll book the table anyway. I mean, you can't have an engagement dinner without a geezer who's getting engaged, can you? Now, go on, shift yourself. Yeah. Now little Jim's getting spliced, I'm going to promote him. And then... I want to concentrate and on writing an autobiography.
Listen, about this marriage.
Oh, we're having it on the night of the All Britain final.
Well, I thought little Jim was in no hurry.
I've done my speech. It's a cracker.
Does Jim know you're doing all this?
Jim who?
It is his son.
By rights, he should come to me on his knees and say, thank you, Larry, thank you. I mean, if it weren't for me, there wouldn't be a do. Anyway. He ain't got a pot to piss in. And even if he did, he'd probably miss. We're all waiting, you know. The tribe are all downstairs starving to death, girl.
I feel awful again, Larry.
What's the matter?
I cried in Marks and Spencer's food hall this morning.
Why?
I don't know.
Bloody prices, I expect.
Can I stay here tonight, Larry? Read me book. We've got a discussion with the literary circle in the morning. I feel like death.
You get yourself better, babes. That's the main thing, eh? I'll go downstairs and entertain the troops.
Don't bully little Jim.
He loves me.
If we had a son.
I don't bully him any road. I spoil him. You can't tell the difference.
Life is about building towards one moment.
All my mum's catalogue money's on this race.
There has to be one moment that is the high point of one's life, and after that moment, everything else is strangely stupefying.
And our moment's going to be the final.
Maybe I've had mine, my friend. Maybe I've had mine.
You've just gone all James Dean on us because your boy ain't here.
Go on, then. There you go. Come on.
Come on, Larry, come on, Glory, go on the black boat.
in, boy. She only had 20p on the tote.
Hey, your mum will be pleased with a catalogue money.
Why? She don't know I've got it.
First, track two, or it's going to be overnight in the morning.
I thought the Martians had whisked you away to Alpha Centauri.
I got the bus.
We're in the final, babes. Tomorrow, Sammy will tell us if Blubberguts is going to join us.
Come on, Porker. Come and have a go if you think you're hard enough.
I want to go back to Billericay tonight.
Eh?
Larry's dog will win you semi-final, and then you two will fight it out for the big prize. I've had enough.
Yay!
Yes! Not Larry!
May I be the first to congratulate you?
Did you ever doubt it?
Oh, well.
We've done it, babes.
You've done it yourself.
Ah, you made me who I am today. Come here.
What's this?
Wedding present. Silly shot. You'll be coming managing director and get the keys to this little gaff and a tasty motor the day you get married.
It's just a moat.
Ladies and gents, the day of the All Britain final, in a month's time, we'll see little Jim here, a married man.
Hooray!
And my new managing director.
Oh, yes!
We're having a wedding breakfast back at my place. Then we're moving everybody up to Stowe to watch my dog win the final. And it's going to be the best bloody day of our lives.
Yeah! I thought you had been groomed for managing director.
Oh, dear. Here, you want to get yourself down millets? You can't turn up the church looking like that.
Oh, can't we get you on blockbusters?
Untie me, will you? This is Larry's idea of best man's duties.
Oh, missus wants me to have a bath before the off. She don't want me in church smelling of milk. Here, we got you a kitchen clock.
Was it worth it?
You gotta have a stag do, ain't ya? Little Jim loved it. We nicked the rope from the flagpole at the town hall.
Suppose if he was your real son, we'd all be having to traipse off to Westminster Abbey now.
If they'd done as a marquee in a graveyard, yeah.
You two, get inside, you missed the kickoff, Els.
Darling, had a good pee.
Hey, what the hell do you think you're doing, Marley?
I've got to see my son get wed.
It's a church. You can't take a dog into the church, you cretin.
Jesus was in a lowly stable born.
Suppose you think you're a three wise men.
Better than thinking of the Virgin Mary.
They've still got straw in their boots, and they actually think they can get one over on me.
I knew that bloody Morley would ruin my day.
That's my privilege.
Training up, little Jim. I'd often feel like a leopardess. And I'd bring home a baby gazelle, and he'd play with it. But keeping his claws in, so that eventually the thing will escape. Now, business-wise, of course, if you're soft, and let me tell you, lovely people, if you're soft, you end up getting a gazelle's horn up your jacksie.
Yeah. God.
My general philosophy carries on into the rest of life. I mean, if it weren't for me, little Jim here wouldn't be a married man right now.
No, he wouldn't.
No, he'd still be dithering on the precipice of loneliness. Believe it or not, he was too soft to pop the question. Honest. He wrote it down. Look, just four lines. I love you, will you marry me? I mean, that's hardly prolific letter writing, isn't it? Look, I love you, will you marry me? I mean, sure, sure. I think to the business, as it should be in business, it is in life.
That reminds me,
Margaret? Monologue's still going on, is it? And all that Attenborough stuff was fine. But when he got to the bit about saving the children, I come over all nauseous.
I want to know the truth about you and Jim.
It was nothing, Margaret.
It's something. I need to know.
When we were both on our own, we saw each other. It was nothing. I haven't seen him since you moved to your new place.
I saw you at the Stowe the night of our semi. I don't want a load of bunkum. I want the truth.
I had to see him, that's all. Just see him. To know in my head it was a full stop and not a comma. I was exorcising a ghost, Margaret, honest.
I wish I hadn't been so bloody pathetic. Having him back sure as hell exorcised something for me. I don't want to be hugged. I just want to feel better on my son's wedding day.
What is it with you? You get pleasure out of ruining my life, do you?
Pops, Pops!
Don't you pops me. Don't you ever pops me again. I don't know you.
You foisted it on me.
Oh, it's my fault now, is it? You break my heart and it's down to me.
Wait a minute. I'm the one who's ended up married, so don't start your quivering it campaign.
You never think of me.
I end up tied to a lamppost with a four-bedroom wimpy home in Romford and a Toyota MR2 because I was thinking of you. You done me again.
Why'd you have to stick your snoz in?
Oh, just what I need.
No more, Morley. No more.
Oh, very Friday the 13th.
You thought I was just a fly in the ointment, didn't you? Well, think again.
Look, sod off.
Tonight, life is going to turn sour for Larry, and you're going to make sure his dog doesn't win that race.
What?
I don't give a damn how you do it, but if Son of War wins, I'm going to spit fuel on the fire of your father's anger by telling him precisely who it was that torched Chadwell Heath. And of course, his videos.
You would.
Yes, I would. Sucker.
Lauren, I found you. This, all this, it's just a sham. See, the thing is, that note, it was mine. Mine. For you. I love you. Let's go.
What are you doing, Jim?
You weren't to know, but I've loved you all along.
Oh, stop it, Jim. Stop it now.
You know that note? What everyone thought was from little Jim to Debbie. Well, it weren't. It was from me to you. Come on, let's fly the coop.
Fly the coop where to?
Jersey, no tax.
Oh, welcome to the planet Earth, Jim. Been here long? Look, you and me were never meant to be.
Why not?
Because I'm with Larry.
I know you think I'm a bit of a disaster, but I've just been plagued by a run of bad luck.
It's more than that, though, Jim.
Tonight, you're going to see a new name on the cup. Jim Morley. And I want you to be there to share the moment with me.
Life is a many tangled web.
It's simple, Lauren. Come with me and be happy.
Come and have a chin wag with Noddy Older. He thinks no one recognises him.
I can't believe this is just a spare bedroom. From now on, all this and Larry Patterson are the enemy.
Well, I'm going to marry the cook because I've never had such decent grub.
Look, you two, start focusing. Let's get victory in our sights. Let's know the whites of the enemy's eyes, see them and reach for the cup.
There's one door opens, another one shuts.
And you know what door's just opened up to you two, symbolised by the marriage of your child? The door to middle age. And you ain't got no option but to go through the poxy thing. I know, I've been there.
I've got to talk to you, Margaret.
I know you have.
I hate to do this to you again.
Would it help if I did it?
What do you mean?
Because maybe I'm as miserable with you as you are with me. I love you. That's why I'm going to let you go. I've stuck it out till our son got married. You waited down, Billericay. You can't stand being a caretaker. It's just the thought of you burning for someone else that makes me feel miserable. You've got to get out there, Jim, and do what you believe in. I'm much better off without you.
I'm much better off without me and all. I haven't got any choice.
What's it like being married, then?
You should know.
Why? I kept my fingers crossed during my wedding service.
There you are. Having a nice time, little Jim.
Blinding.
What you two been chuntering on about?
Marriage.
I hope and I pray that you and Debbie will be as happy and contented with each other as me and Lauren.
Thanks.
I'm going to bury the hatchet with your father. We're family now. Come on.
What you got to gain out of his dog losing, then?
Pleasure.
Oh, I can't believe this. You're blackmailing me.
Don't be such a negative little git. Just look on your tiny chore as saving Larry's marriage.
And how am I doing that?
Because if you don't, I'll tell Lauren who taught Chadwell to heave, that... And then he'll have no marriage. From now on, I win.
What am I supposed to do with these?
Crush the aspirin up, put a bit of the powder on the end of your finger and dip it in the urine sample. It's the oldest trick in the book to get a dog disqualified.
Not a bad little gaff, eh?
Sod to heat, though, isn't it?
It's only money, Jim.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
Come on. That's something you ain't been able to come to terms with. We have him more than you.
What gaineth a man if he hath the world but loseth his soul?
Eh?
What profiteth a man if he potteth 15 reds but potteth not one colour?
We all got to eat, Jim. I know how hard it is on a man not being able to support his own flesh and blood. See, that's why I'm willing to give you a new start in the warehouse.
And maybe you could be our butler.
I only want for us to be pals. See, all friends today and all differences forgotten. I'm going to mash you tonight in a race, though. No hard feelings, eh?
Tonight, I'm going to prove I'm a better man than you.
Debbie! Oh, this is delicious, ain't it, eh? My friends and family all around me. Give us a cuddle, Lauren. This is their life.
Judas! You've been bought by that evil bit of blubber, ain't you?
No, no! Oh, Dad, it's not for your dog, it's for Larry's.
I never realised what an evil little sod you were.
Honest, Pops, it's for Son of War.
Welcome to the planet Earth. Been here long, obviously think I haven't.
All right, I'll come clean with you. Pilbeam's trying to blackmail me. That's why I got to nobble Larry's dog.
How's Pilbeam blackmailing you?
He thinks he's got something.
You're a lying, conniving, horrible yuck.
It's the truth, Dad.
You lose me my woman, now you're trying to lose me my race. From now on, all things hard done by shall be known as Jim, and all perpetrators of evil, little Jim.
Everything I've done has been to keep you and Mum and Larry and Lauren together.
If my dog loses tonight, we'll know who it's down to.
Hey, isn't this just the best do ever? If I hadn't thrown this party, they'd have no presents. So, everything they got is from me, really, isn't it?
Tom.
It's smoked salmon.
I ate fish.
How fascinating.
So those tiddly bones.
Now, dear, it gives me no joy to have to be the one to tell you this, but, well, the truth will out. It's about this note. Mm-hmm. Well...
Right, everybody, shut up. Bit of hush. Now, I'm leading the first battalion up the stove. The last one there gets fed to my dog. Once he's the new champion, eh?
Yeah, nice little abode, Lauren. Can see now why you weren't so keen to give all this up and go and live in a bed and breakfast with Jim Morley.
Split loyalties for you tonight, I guess. Who's your money going on?
What money?
Hello, Debbie. Being set. At least you still love me, eh?
Told me you wanted that note as a surprise.
She just got a surprise.
I thought it was going to be a nice surprise.
It's lucky your father's who he is, or you'd be stuck behind the bulb counter at Woolies for the rest of your life. Where's Jean?
What do you want her for?
Another hornet's nest needs stirring.
And they say this is the best day of your life.
Of course he loves you.
He's got a funny way of showing it.
Well, he wanted to marry you. He didn't have to.
I think I'm a late cancellation.
I don't care how it looks. He loves you, I know. I've been loved too. Hard to believe, I know. But someone once sat in a windowsill and was willing to jump for me.
This has hurt me to the quick. Little Jim betting on glory's gonna be. Are you sure you're right on that?
Haven't you never heard of the Trojan horse? You know, get on the inside to cause the damage.
All I've done for that git breaks my heart.
He's got his father's blood. And if he's looking after your dog and betting on his father, something evil's going down.
Right, Larry? What are you doing?
My dog.
I know that, don't I?
But if you don't come first, I'm holding you personally responsible.
Why?
Bloody because. Come on.
There will be proper nosh served continuously throughout the evening in my exec. Unless, of course, you've had your fill.
A man needs more than food alone to satisfy his hunger.
That's some plonky way of saying you think you're in with a shout.
Any time, Patterson.
Any time back to you.
Learn to sing your own song.
How old are you, mate?
Cut off my leg, count the rings.
Wouldn't cost me a lot to have that done.
That's your philosophy, isn't it? I got you sus, blubbers. Think you can buy anything? My son, Lauren.
What's she got to do with anything?
She's the only person in the history of the world who's ever liked you. I can't think of one other person from junior school up to the present day who's thought you half decent. You ain't got a friend in the world because everyone thinks you're such a porker. Because you use and abuse. I think you can throw money at people by way of an apology. You're always last in line when we were picking sides at school. Nobody wanted you with them.
Yeah. But now I'm the captain. I pick the team. You know what you're going to be eating later on tonight? Your words.
Oh, that's funny. That is very funny. It's bloody hilarious. Lend me a pen, I'll write it down. Send it to Barry Cryer.
If I may quote ABBA, the winner takes it all.
I only slapped you around the face because you didn't write the note.
No, oh, found out, did you?
But you wouldn't have married me if you didn't want to, eh?
Run out of ideas. Harry's dog don't win, I'm sunk. Dad's dog don't win, I'm sunk.
Well, two dogs can't win one race.
nothing can save me now. I never thought the world would end for me here. Doomsday at Walthamstow Stadium.
Well, can I do anything to help?
Christmas cards we get last year?
I don't know.
I'll tell you, loads. I've got loads of friends, me. Haven't I, Lauren?
Why don't we let them win?
Who?
Jim and the others.
Get out of here.
Well, you've got everything. What have they got?
If I let them win, they'll have the All Britain Cup for a bleeding start.
Larry. If I promised to make you happier than you'd ever dreamed, would you pull your dog out of the race?
Why are you asking me this?
Because I need to know you understand there's more to life than winning.
You'd love that, wouldn't you?
What?
That's why you're behaving like a Barbie doll all of a sudden.
What are you talking about?
You think you're going to get around me like that, do you? Also...
Also what?
I know what you're all about.
I wish I did.
Deserve a better son.
You're all right, boy. You got in with the wrong crowd.
Well, I've got to say, Morley, that Debbie will fit well into your family. You're all mad and all.
You're one devious bastard, ain't you?
No.
You're lucky she'd done that. My dog would have done you.
No, it wouldn't.
Tonight, head to head.
When the stadium's emptied. Your dog against my dog, then. Well, it takes both.
Don't say goodbye to your now, because tonight I'm going to prove to Lauren you're no longer king of the castle.
Wars have always been about winning. I don't see this as any different. 30 seconds he's gonna see you with nothing.
That's what you reckon, is it, blubber?
I'm gonna finish you.
No, I'm gonna finish you, because I've got right on my side.
Well, I'd say things are going rather well. Perhaps you're my little bonne chance charm.
Your bridal gown's a goner.
You really do love me, don't you?
So it's a sob to shift.
Everyone else is gimme, 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 but you?
Of course I love you, little Jim. Has the penny only just dropped?
I love you too. I want to be with you for the rest of my life.
Thank you. gonna win, Morley. And you're gonna pack your bags and leave town.
The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Suppose you think you're clever talking crap like that. The whole world knows you're stupid.
Sometimes you gotta fight to be a man.
The person you were angry with was Larry.
I've been saving his nemesis till now. I'm going to shatter that man's world into a million pieces. Oh, hello, Mrs. Patterson. Or should I say Mrs. Midas? Mrs. Patterson, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, as twere, but if I don't, somebody else will. It was, in fact, Larry who burnt down Chadwell Heath. Still, I dare say it'll all come out in the wash.
Thank you for that, Stephen.
Tell him.
Well, congratulations, Larry. You just won your dog back. It was your dog in the first place. Me and Jim nicked it.
No, you didn't. It was just a sour middle-aged freak. I don't think your ramblings are going to upset my night of triumph.
Oh, triumph. That's what it's all about, then, is it?
Yeah, stupid. You go off with your loser. I want you to know what that feels like.
The only way you're gonna be able to understand me.
Stars that never were are parking cars or pumping gas. Don't mind losing the dog. But without you, I don't feel complete.
You wouldn't want me if you knew.
I just feel like crying.
something I've been trying to tell you. It's going to be the final nail.
She's yours, mate. You're bleeding welcome.
Larry.
It's good riddance to the both of you scumbags.
Please.
She's the booby prize.
She's all right.
I've done you, Morley. I said I wouldn't, I have. I've done you.
Larry.
Come on.
I'm carrying that man's child.
Is that what you're worried about? That don't matter. I can live with that.
I think we should go back for her.
What for? We don't need her. Me and you. We're fine on our own. We can cope. You're proud of me, ain't you?
Thing is, I think she might be pregnant.
Do what? She's in whelp. And I'm the sire. Right. Here. I've got... Lauren! Lauren! Lauren!
Of course. It might not be Larry's.
I once had a woman. She treated me too kind. I took her for granted, and I thought that she'd always be mine. But now I'm a loner. I don't like being by myself. The kind of love I'm looking for, I can't find with nobody else. Boy, Chill is gone. No, you don't know.